So let's talk about how I became fluent in Russian. Говорить о том, как я стал свободно говорить по-русски. So I'm Dutch, which means that Russian is not my native language. And in this video, I just want to go over a timeline, basically, and my story of how I became fluent in Russian. You'll find it interesting because you'll be able to relate, basically see what might lie ahead of you, what the timeline approximately would be. Plus, you'll also find the struggles that I had, which you can see how I overcame them. Plus, there will be plenty of other tips that you can also use to become fluent in Russian. Let's get started. Okay, so first of all, I was never a genius in learning languages or anything. Actually, on the other hand, in high school, I would find every language class the most boring class that we had, because we had English, Dutch, German, and French. And all of them I considered kind of pointless at that time, because my English was already good, because I was just, you know, watching movies, playing a lot of video games when I was younger, all in English. Dutch already spoke, so why learn it even more? And German and French, well, they kind of speak English, so why would you need to learn those languages? So I'm not a language genius or anything, not at all. So I remember very clearly the point in time when my interest in learning Russian actually got peaked, and this was in November 2014. I was 21 years old at the time, and I had a colleague at a student job, and he moved to Holland from Russia when he was 2 years old. So, and he still spoke Russian with his mother at home. And we were good friends, and at a certain point we were sitting, you know, drinking beer in a bar after work, and he's like, okay, so you know that I'm from Russia, so do you want to learn some Russian words? Because he was like, you know, I want to share this with you. I was like, yeah, sure. Почему бы и нет? No, back then I didn't know that. So the first Russian words that I learned were "Но ты, блин, козёл," which basically translates to, well, you're a damn goat. So that's when my interest in Russian language got piqued. So after learning this word stream, I was like, okay, Russian sounds like a cool language. How can I learn more of this? So I decided to just go online, and I found some audio courses, basically. I just started listening to it, but I probably listened to it for maybe like 5 to 10 hours, which is not a lot, but it allowed me to learn, like, the, you know, the basic alphabet and maybe 10 to 20 phrases. And probably half a year later, I completely stopped doing that, because I thought, well, I don't have a real reason to learn Russian except for the fact that it sounds cool. Plus I thought, like, what am I gonna do with the Russian language? So I maybe learned a couple of basic phrases, like, я не знаю, что я здесь делаю, я говорю по-русски, back then with a horrible accent as well. Like, now my accent has gotten a lot better over the years, but back then I just learned a couple of basic phrases, and like, for nothing. So then I basically took a decision that completely changed the way I looked at languages, because I made the decision to study for a year in Spain, in Madrid. So back then I thought, well, now I really need to seriously understand how to learn a foreign language, because if you don't know Spanish in Spain, it's going to be quite difficult to live there a normal life, or at least that's what I thought. So I tried learning Spanish with, again, audio courses, apps, movies, and everything. But when I was in Spain, it kind of completely failed, because I was only living among a bubble of international students. So in the end, I was just speaking English a lot. But then something that changed my life happened. So there was a cute Russian girl in my class, so you can already guess what happened next. At a certain point, we were talking a little bit, and I blurred out some of the Russian words that I still knew from like 1.5 years ago or so, when I tried to learn a little bit of Russian. She found that quite interesting. Then we started communicating more. Basically, we started dating, first not too seriously for a couple of months, but then things became more seriously. And then after a couple of months of dating, she's like, okay, do you want to travel to Russia to see my family? Because she was going for the summer holidays for 2 weeks. She was going to go back to Moscow. And I was like, yeah, sure, I would love to go. It would be very interesting to see Russia with my own eyes. But now there was a problem, basically, because if you know anything about Russia, you probably know that the level of English in Russia is not that good. So if I was going to travel there, like, my Russian was super, super basic. I still probably only knew like 20, 30 phrases, because we were just dating because we liked each other, not because I wanted to learn Russian. And so I had basically 1.5 months, I think. It was May when we, no, April when we got the tickets, 2016. We were going to travel in June. So I was like, what do I need to do in order to quickly get my Russian good up? Because her parents did not speak any English. Many other people there, it was 2016. So right now, like 5 years later, the English of young people has gotten better. But back then, like, Like I spoke to people basically my age, and their English was bad basically. So I needed to find a way to improve my Russian quickly. So what I did during those 1.5 months, I just listened to a huge amount of podcasts in Russian. I watched a lot of series, installed apps. Like I took a list of 2,000 most common words and I just typed them all into basically an app that you can use for flashcards, which took a lot of words and probably helped me to learn those words as well. And it turned out that that had actually worked quite well. Because when I got to Russia for 2 weeks, we went first to Moscow, then to St. Petersburg. We also went to Tver, which is a small city between Moscow and St. Petersburg. We also went down to the Black Sea in order to chill at the sea. And I had a great experience because I figured out that my crash course in Russian, where I spent maybe in total 50 to 100 hours on, was enough to have basic conversations. I mean, I could talk, remember at a certain point sitting at a table and there was so much tasty food. It was very tasty, lots of alcohol as well. And I just thought that because I learned a lot of vocabulary as well, I could just point at everything, like, you know, хлеб, помидор, огурец, самогон. Like I knew a lot of words and I could also basically have normal conversations. And I realized that this time, because I also spent a lot of time practicing there, that my approach to learning a foreign language actually was quite successful. And I found that very cool. So after Russia, I decided to go back to Holland to do my internship there because the economic situation in Holland is and was a little bit better than that of Spain. And my girlfriend, we decided that she was gonna try and get a visa to also come to Holland. And that took basically a year. That was a horrible year because we were basically waiting and all the visa stuff was not working out. And I do not recommend that if you like a long distance relationship, not at all. But during those time, we saw each other once a month, probably. I sometimes went to Russia, she sometimes went to Holland. And I just continued learning Russian because, well, why not? I mean, now things were serious and it was very cool to learn more Russian to basically get to know her culture better. And you know, I was enjoying it as well. So basically what I did, I was working full time. So in the mornings while biking to work, because, you know, still Dutch, I just listened to audio podcasts. And then at night, I was just playing video games in Russian or watching series in Russian sometimes, sometimes with English subtitles, sometimes without, depending on the level. And that's basically how things continued then. So then finally, my girlfriend was able to come to Holland and we started living together in the end of 2017. And basically we were speaking in a mix of English and Russian at home because my Russian was had already gotten quite good. And then we also added Dutch to the mix because we were still in Holland. So she needed to learn Dutch in order to get a normal job here, which all worked out and I'm happy with that. But basically in 2019, there was another step that then helped me a lot to improve my Russian, to basically усовершенствовать, to, you know, make it complete. It's still improving every day and I'm not completely... I didn't call it like an, I don't speak like a native speaker and probably never will. But back then I was intermediate in Russian and I wanted to improve it even more to become very good because it's better to speak one language, very good, one foreign language instead of, you know, try to become a polyglot and speak like 10 languages all, like very little, which I don't think there's a point in that. But in order to become better, I stopped listening to courses because I already knew a lot of things. And then I found some YouTube channels of other foreigners speaking Russian, like Justin and Когда ты Нуря, like a Canadian guy and a Spanish girl. And their Russian was, you know, a lot of Russian people found it interesting. Plus, they also noticed that because they were speaking a lot of Russian, you know, to the camera, that their Russian got a lot better. And then I decided to also try a video like that. And people liked it a lot. I uploaded it to the Russian Reddit and then, you know, things took off from there. So for the last 2.5 years, basically, I've been spending like once a week, once every 2 weeks, spend like 10 to 30 minutes just speaking Russian, like having a monologue with the camera. And that helped pretty much because at a certain point, like you run out of easy topics to talk about. You need to start talking about more difficult topics. So you basically get a lot of practice to really clearly try and formulate a sentence in Russian. So I would recommend it to you, not to start a YouTube channel, but just to film yourself or record yourself while speaking, because that has a, and try to speak something coherent, because that has a great way to help you improve your Russian. So if you also want to speak Russian very well, I recommend you do a lot of those things that I did. If you want like a specific program on how I did it, then check out the link in the description for my Russian conversational blueprint, which will teach you exactly how to become fluent in Russian. So check out the link. Спасибо вам большое за просмотр и желаю вам хорошего дня. Пока.